Ford Foundation, this question of leadership is a very broad one for us. It's not just about business education. And when you, I'm very happy that our two deans of business schools are talking about diversity. And so it's wonderful if you are have a diverse student population, and it's wonderful if they're global in nature and come from all over the world. But if they actually don't have the right values, and they aren't being taught, and they aren't having leadership modeled, it really doesn't matter. I mean, I quite frankly am not interested in being around another African American or gay man who has bad values and is a really, I think, a greedy person, not really concerned about the world around him. So to my mind, it is that core issue of what kind of leaders are we generating today for tomorrow? How do we think about a population of people who can lead, motivate, manage, model a behavior, a style, a quality of leadership that inspires and that helps society be lifted up, and who think in a very different, disruptive way? And how do we think about the ecosystem in which they have to operate, where incentives are actually the right incentives to get them to be the best they can be rather than the worst they can be? And so that's what we're interested in, the broader ecosystem. And what I'm excited about is there seems to be a movement afoot. It is somewhat atomized at this point, and Judy has been leading the charge for a while, very courageously, during a time when Milton Friedman and that whole idea of what the role of the firm should be seemed to be the dominant paradigm. I think, I hope we have put the nail in the coffin of that idea, but maybe not.